There are many wolves in sheep's clothing all around us. There is a Japanese folktale, Deep Divers, which goes like this. Each one of us has three faces. The first face is the face we show to the world. The second face is the face we show to our close friends and family. And the third face is the face that nobody sees. And that is the truest reflection of who you really are. Now, I say this. We all have three versions of ourselves, including the cat down the road. The first version is who we show to the world. The side of ourselves we show to the world every single day. The second version is how we see ourselves in our minds. And the third version is who we actually are. And sometimes we don't even know who we really are. We don't even know all the sides of ourselves. We don't even know that we have a shadow side. Each one of us has a shadow side. And until you face it, you are never ever gonna activate your true potential. Deep Divers, we got a whole lot to talk about. Peace, infinite waters, diving deep once again. Beautiful Deep Divers, we are out here in the heart of nature, baby. We got the sun shining. We got butterflies all over the place. We got the cat down the road. I'm in a zen state, Deep Divers. Just, woo! Breathing in that good ass prana, baby. Sending you tons of light and darkness. Huh? Yes, take those shadows, and take those shadows. Shadow work 101 explained. Now, are you aware that you might be repressing your shadow side? We all are, to some extent. And the whole of life is actually about no longer suppressing that shadow side. No longer being afraid of the darkness. Were you afraid of the dark as a child? Many people in this matrix are wolves in sheep's clothing. On the outside, it looks fantastic. I'll buy it. But on the inside, there's a monster lurking. Each one of us has an angel and demon within us. Each one of us has dark and light within us. But in this society, you have been told to be ashamed of the darker side of yourself. You have been told to be ashamed and to feel guilty about the undesirable aspects of yourself. So, throughout life, a lot of people suppress their shadow side until one day, it comes out at the most unexpected time. And people are like, oh my gosh, I can't believe she said that. Oh my gosh, I can't believe he said that. You see, if you don't learn about your shadow side and do shadow work, it's gonna come out. And it might come out at a very inconvenient time. And we ain't even had breakfast yet. Can I get a hello there? So wonderful, Deep Divers. Let me share with you what's helped me along my journey. Shadow work 101. What is shadow work? Simply put, it's when you learn that we all have unconscious personality disorders. We all have a dark side to us. We all have things which society calls unacceptable, not allowed, undesirable. We are all deeply flawed. We all have a hidden dark side to us. Not just peace, love, and light, and kumbaya. No, a lot of us, we have a monster inside of us. And it's not a bad thing. In fact, it's natural. Your shadow side is natural. When you turn your back to the sun, a shadow forms. Shadows are natural. If you are a photographer, you know that you need shadows, midtones, and highlights to get the perfect exposure. But in our society, we call dark things bad and light things good. That is why growing up, a lot of people have suppressed their emotions, and there is a lot of repression going on with so many people. We only want to be seen as living a perfect life, but that's not reality. The truth of the matter is, a lot of us, we got a whole lot of skeletons in our closet. Now, Ralph, what's your shadow? Because you always seem to be smiling. Deep divers, I'm telling you my shadows. I'm expressing my shadow side every single day. I'm talking about COVID-19, we ain't having it. I'm talking about, hey, I think that nobody should be wearing a face mask 24/7 because it causes hypoxia, people can't breathe. I feel that the whole world is a stage. I feel that we got to stand up for what we believe in. I feel that this whole thing is planned. This whole pandemic is total nonsense. Oh my gosh, Ralph, I can't believe you said it. Yeah, I said it. And what? That's my shadow side coming out, deep divers. I've made videos that most people would be afraid to talk about in their whole existence. Because for a long time, I had thoughts in my mind, deep divers, like, actually, I feel a certain way about this, but I was afraid to talk about it. So I would repress my feelings and emotions and suppress them as well. Then one day I said, hey, I can no longer hold this in. Then I just said, this whole thing is a joke. This whole matrix is so fake. And I started to allow my shadow side to come out. And it freed me. It liberated me. You see, once you learn to own your shadow side 100%, it will actually be the gateway to your freedom, the gateway to your self-healing. When you realize that actually there are so many different sides to yourself that you have to learn about. A lot of us in this matrix, we wear a happy mask, or we just wear a mask. It's not who we really are. You at your job, just over broke. Sometimes you have to be a certain way, otherwise you're going to get fired, right? Right. So a lot of us, we realize that certain behaviors are rewarded in society and certain behaviors are shunned upon. Now, a lot of us, we have a tendency to always be liked by other people. That's why the like button is huge, right? In social media and in society. A lot of people don't like to be an outcast. A lot of people do not like to be unpopular. A lot of people don't like to be a fringe dweller. Well, in actuality, that is your shadow side. It is the undesirable aspects of yourself. It is the flawed you. It is the you nobody knows about. It is the darker side of you, not just the peace, love, and light. It's also the anger, the frustration, the madness. You want to pull out your hair. Ah! It's the screaming side of you. Now, how do we access that? We have to learn how to lose this persona, which is this social mask. And talking of face masks, we ain't having it. We gotta learn to speak our heart and mind. We got to learn how to speak our heart and mind every single day without sugarcoating it. We got to learn how to embrace a bit of truth instead of a sweet lie. What? Slow motion this side. We got to get real with ourselves and stop putting on a front. A lot of us, we hide our shadows and we replace them with lights, flashing lights. Hey, look at me, my life is perfect on social media or in real life, it's perfect. No, it's not. When we can learn how to be honest, our shadow springs forth. When we can learn how to be vulnerable, our shadow springs forth. I've been making a lot of videos exposing this whole pandemic, and a lot of people have been watching them. A lot of those videos have gone viral, but I'm like, wait a minute, why aren't other people making videos as well about how they feel? You see, they are, that could be you, repressing their shadow side. They feel what I'm saying, but they're afraid to say it because they don't want their shadow to come out. Because everybody knows them to be this goody-goody two-shoes. Me, I don't care what you think. I am that I am. Shadow work 101. You have to realize this. Life is not just about kumbaya, meditation under a tree. Life is not just about nirvana. Life is not just about seeing the positive in everything. It's also seeing the negative in everything. You see, if you look at a battery, you got negative and positive. But it's the one force. So what happens if you disregard the negative? What happens if you disregard the shadows? There is no power. Your true power comes from owning your shadow side to make sure you realize that your shadow side is not negative. In fact, it can become your best friend because it can help you work on areas of yourself you didn't know you had to work on. Like, shadow work begins when you become conscious of your shadow. Now, I'll expose myself right now. You see, that's how B Rabbit won the battle in 8 Mile. He exposed himself so nobody can use his past against him. He exposed himself. That's what I do every single day. I say, actually, my life's been rough. Actually, I'm not perfect. Actually, I was hospitalized. Actually, sometimes I can be pretty rude to people, deep divers. Because people always say, Ralph, you're so compassionate. But sometimes I can be a total asshole, but I own it. That's the shadow side. Awareness. To say, actually, sometimes I've got a monster lurking inside of me. And that's okay. Sometimes I can be really annoying. And that's okay. Sometimes I can get really angry. And that's okay. Sometimes I can get really frustrated about what's happening. I can get really frustrated about what's happening on this planet. I feel like lockdowns are totally out of order. I feel like mandatory face masks are totally out of order. I feel it's like a form of child abuse, right? When you start to say how you really feel, that's embracing your shadow side. When you stop worrying about what other people think of you, that's embracing your shadow side. So I had to learn that actually, I wasn't just this saint. I was also the sinner at the same time. What? Slow motion this side. When we talk of shadow work 101 explained, you have to realize a lot of us, we have unresolved issues. We have childhood trauma. Unresolved issues, childhood trauma. A childhood trauma I had when I was actually doing the work, the shadow work, was actually because I was always traveling as a child. I was born in London, but I've lived in West Africa, Sierra Leone. I've lived in Sudan, I've lived in Ethiopia, I've been all around the world. And because I was always moving around, I never had a home. And that was an unresolved issue I had. I could never actually be in one place. And it was sometimes hard for me to connect with other people because I'm like, hey, I've got to move soon, right? So it's when you realize all of these unresolved issues that you have within yourself and you learn how to make peace with them. This is how to uncover your shadow side. When you recognize the unresolved issues within yourself, a lot of people have issues of attachment because maybe they were abandoned as children and they feel everyone is going to abandon them. So they really hold on, right? So we have to learn who we are today is a result of who we were yesterday, the traumas we endured. And this is what shadow work is. It's when you actually go back to your childhood and say, okay, that really screwed me up back then and is still screwing me up right now, but now I can do something about it. You see, this is how you learn how to integrate your shadow. Every single day, I want you to realize in our society, we think that everything that is dark is negative. The dark night of the soul. That's so negative, Ralph. No, because in our darkest moments, we become illuminated. What? Slow motion this side. Like, be honest, deep divers. How many times have you gone through a really dark experience, a really dark day? But afterwards, you're like, oh my gosh, I learned so much, Ralph. Oh my gosh, it made me a stronger person. Oh my gosh, it taught me the biggest lesson of my life. You see, it takes the darkness for us to become illuminated. It takes the darkness for us to become wise. So we have to form a better relationship to the dark side and realize it's not negative. In fact, it's our biggest friend, our best friend, our biggest helper, because it makes us see things we couldn't see before. If you look at the English language, just poke your nose into a dictionary. Everything white is good, everything black is bad. Black male, black market. So, whitelisting. So you have been conditioned and programmed to believe that darkness is something negative, when in actuality, that is your freedom ticket. Because I told you, everything in this matrix is in reverse. The dark night only in the dark night can you see the star shining. I want you to always remind yourself of that. Now, when we talk of shadow work and how we go about it, it's about realizing you have to say the stuff that's scary. Because suppression is depression. And that's why a lot of people, oh, they're going to be in for a rude awakening once that shadow is let outside of the bag. Because it's going to come out. It's inevitable. You might have to tell your parents something, but you're afraid. You might have to tell your friends something, but you're afraid to speak up. Now, this creates an even bigger shadow because they don't really know who you are or how you feel. You see, shadow work begins when you really learn how to open your throat chakra and say what you mean and mean what you say. I do that in every one of my videos. I regret nothing. What you're seeing, I'm bearing my soul out here and I'm speaking my heart and mind. I don't care what anybody thinks. Oh my gosh. Yeah, that's the shadow. And that's why we find the empowerment there. So stop suppressing your emotions. Stop biting your tongue. And if you feel a certain way about this whole pandemic, start speaking up and start staying true, because it's actually when you realize your shadow side can actually lead to a more authentic life, a life of self-healing. Your shadow side, in actuality, is your authenticity. What? Slow motion this side. And you know what, deep divers? What? I had to leave a fake life to embrace this real life, where I could actually express my shadow side. Because in that fake life in the Matrix, I had to suppress it. Now people know who I really am. Do you know how many friends I have out of the blue? Oh my gosh, Ralph, I've seen your videos. I didn't know you were like this. You're so inspiring. You really make me think. Now they know me. I don't know them. Because they're hiding who they really are. I'm exposing it. Shadow work 101. Have a shadow work journal and write in every single day. Have a shadow work journal and write in it every single day. I want you to write. I want you to check yourself. Like, because we often feel that we are all angels and saints, when in actuality, we're no different sometimes than other people down the road. Right? Write about all of your flaws. Write about all of these undesirable aspects of yourself every single day that you notice. You see, once again, once you realize that shadow work begins when you are more mindful of your everyday actions, without, keyword, without judgment, it's more about acceptance. It's more about being an observer of your daily attitudes and actions. And the more you observe who you really are, the more you will stumble across who you really are. The more you will begin to know thyself. Know thyself. And you have to learn never to judge how you feel, never to judge how you act. Just observe it. Never to judge how you feel about someone else. It could be really negative. Don't judge it. Just observe it. And then you'll start to find out, okay, maybe there's some work I need to work on. Like, why am I envious of someone else? That's your shadow side. Maybe because I'm coming to the realization that I don't have what they have. Okay, now we're getting somewhere, right? So that's what shadow work is. Learn to question. Questioning. Learn to question why you feel the way you do. Learn to question your actions. Learn to question your beliefs. Learn to question your motives. I want you to remind yourself every single day. It's not about running from the darkness. It's about integrating the darkness into yourself. To say, actually, I am the light and I am the darkness. I am the good and I am the bad. I am the positive and I am the negative. Now we become more authentic, more real. And that's what shadow work is. It's total integration. Total integration without judgment, guilt, or shame. And to do that, you have to be willing to expose yourself. You have to be willing to ruin your reputation. You have to be willing to throw yourself into the lion's den and then become the lion. And roar, 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 deep divers. And then just say, feels so good to be alive, baby. Can I get a hello there? 7-day vegan challenge. Shout out to everybody who is not only eating leafy greens and fruits and vegetables, but also taking a day off just to stuff their face with vegan junk food. That's your shadow side. And that's okay. Deep divers, I'm just, woo, breathing in that good ass prana, baby. I love all of you deep divers. Shout out to everybody who's been getting the wonderful Good Ass Prana shirts at ralphsmart.com/clothes and spreadshirt.com. And if you are a sexy ass model, woo, with a whole lot of heart, who wants to model the clothing, show me what you got. Deep divers, and go and buy some. Got a question for me? Add me on the verified Instagram page at @officialralphsmart, at Infinite Waters, and Facebook at Ralph Smart, at Infinite Waters. Check out the best-selling book, Deep Divers, for more powerful information like this. Feel Alive by Ralph Smart on Amazon and at ralphsmart.com/the book. It's okay to smile. It's okay to be sad. It's okay to show the world the real you. Oh my gosh, yeah. Kind of shocked me too, but that's okay. Have a beautiful day, Deep Divers. Peace. Infinite Waters, diving deep once again. Stay well, stay healthy. Peace. You! There's who we show the world. There's how we see ourselves. And there's who we really are. When it comes to shadow work, we must begin to realize that we are sometimes not even who we think we are. And we have to allow ourselves to reveal our truth, our true selves to ourselves. And that may not be pretty, could be very ugly, but at least it's the truth. Have a beautiful day, Deep Divers. Peace.